Hello there. Today we're going to talk about Miss Grand Philippines. I'm sure a lot of you are getting fed up with a lot of people who continuously watch or follow Miss Grand International. And it can never be denied the power and the excitement the pageant brings. Kahit pa sabihin walang nagpapapanalo or wala pang nananalong Miss Philippines, let's admit it, whether we like it or not, we love to watch Miss Grand International. Ewan ko sa inyo. Basta, you know, because they give entertainment, they give us a show. So majority of Pinoys tend to be hypocrite that they say they don't want to watch Miss Grand anymore because it is so madaya, it is so lutong Macau, it is so lutong bahay, it is a cooking show, and yet, deep within, andun yung pagnanasa at pagnanais na mapanood ang Miss Grand International because of its uniqueness, its difference from the rest of the pageants because it is the exaggerated Miss Universe competition. Yun na. So this is what, you know, basically this is what beauty pageant is all about. You know, the basic beauty pageant that we used to see, that we used to enjoy, and we still enjoy up to this day. That's why hindi nga tayo bumibitaw sa Miss Grand International. Because it is a beauty pageant per se. Yung bardagulan. A little bit exagerada, pero ito talaga yung bardagulang pageant na wala tayo masyadong iniintindi sa advocacy. Wala tayo masyadong iniintindi because this is not their priority. And that's, you know, within the innermost part of ourselves, that's what we want. Kaya muna tayo magpaka-plastic, abangan natin na Miss Grand Philippines and the Miss Grand International itself. Iyon. So, ang dami ka nang sinabi, sorry ah. Pero, ewan ko, I might not always like the results. I tend to believe sometimes that some Miss Philippines that we have sent deserved higher placements or the title itself. Pero, you know, we enjoy the show. Binakla yung show, pero that's majority of us want. Kaya, go tayo, go. Siyempre, Miss Universe pa rin. At sa mga ayaw panoorin, hindi wag na kayong manood. Ganun lang kasimple yun. Or wag nyo nang sabay-bayan pag pinakita yung Miss Grand International news, or update, or photos, or kahit yung local search ng Miss Grand Philippines, wag nyo panoorin. Inood naman kayo ng nood. Diba? Okay. So nag-record ako dito. Nag-screen recording. So I would like to thank yung mga sources natin. Yung mga nakita lang natin sa internet. And so far, so good. There are 19 at sabi nila first batch pa raw to. So yun, sana wala nang dumating na mas bongga. Sana sila-sila na lang because lutang na si ano. Alam kong tuwang-tuwa ng mga taga Zambales because lutang na lutang si CJ of Yaza. And mamaya sasabihin ko sa inyo yung aking top 5. Isa pang sin stealer is si who also made a big surprise during the Miss Universe pageant. Miss Universe Philippines pageant from Pasig, si Miss Selena and some more girls. Very impressive. I was looking for girls who would display that exaggerated intro. Na tipong, hi, I'm... Di ba yung mga ganon? Wala. Isa lang siguro, pero wala pa rin dating. Sa kanyang salita lang yung Miss, Ma, ngayon, I forgot. So wala talaga. And then may isang girl, I think she's from Pampanga, who keep on tossing her hair. Siguro mga nakapito siyang hair exhibition. Na mapapatawad mo because it's Miss Grand nga na kung ang labanan ay Miss Universe Philippines or Miss or Binibini Pilipinas, maloloka ka na, Diyos ko, inokray, binaboy, dinog show ang competition. dito, hindi ka maghahanap ng mga dog show channels because it is in the first place. Not basically dog show one, kundi baklaan talaga. Baklaan in a positive way. In a positive way. Ang dami na ng mga aso. Pasensya na kayo. We're here at my niece's house. So siguro doon na lang tayo mag-vlog ulit sa bahay. Okay, so siguro bukas doon tayo. Okay, so nagkaroon ng 2 presentation in gown and in swimsuit. Wala nga aso pero ingay naman ng mga sasakyan because we're just maybe 10 feet away from the street. Ganun kalapit. So yun. And I must say that only a few girls, maybe 4 or 5, didn't really perform well. And the rest gave quite impressive performances. Nagkaroon din ng interview and okay. Okay din ang kanilang performances. So, it will be on Sunday. Yan. Correct me if I'm wrong. So, napakabilis. Press presentation and ganoon agad. Hindi ka gaya ng Miss... Sabag, international pageant to. Miss Cosmo na halos din mabuna yata. Eh, parang nasa kalagitnaan pa lang. So, yon. Ang Miss Grand Philippines ay abang-abang sa aspetong bardagulan. Andun si Miss Grand Philippines 2023 and I must say that she's pretty. Sayang at hindi siya napasama sa semi-finalists. Siguro ay mga tipong ano, ang kailangan natin ipadala, yung talagang walang hiya-hiya na talagang grabe mag-perform up kina. Yung pwedeng-pwedeng mag-tumbling sa stage. Yun. Tapos ang ganda-ganda pag naayusan. Like, maybe Hipon Budol. Herlin Budol. O ganun. Ang di ko lang talaga bet nung inilaban natin o nung mapili to represent the Philippines, si Samantha Panlilio ay wala akong masyadong... Hindi ko sinasabing tsaka o hindi ko sinasabing hindi magaling, pero meron ka nung ano eh, meron ka nung... Ang tawag dito? Yung feel, gut feel na nako, mahihirapan to. And then yun nga. And Eva Patalinhook, I also disagreed when she was chosen as Miss Grand Philippines. Pero nung performance siya anyway, I began to like her. Pero yun, hindi pa rin siya naka-place. And of course, Samantha Law. Isa pa yun sa expected ko na mukhang parang wrong choice for that representation. Ang sayang talaga, of course, si Samantha Bernardo. About Nicole, may kamang kasi Nicole dito na contestant ah. About Nicole Cordoves, I mean naman yung hindi, I think she gave a wrong answer. Not because the answer was wrong itself, but because the choice she made wasn't popular. And sometimes, it is not who do you believe is right, it is not how right your answer is, or how safe your answer is, but it's, you know, a popular choice, especially if there are choices, is a better answer. Mm. And she answered Trump. Kahit pa sabihin may conflict, may irony yung kanyang sagot na she chose Trump because of blah, blah, blah. Ay, hindi pa rin. Generally, ang tingin pa rin nila is she favored Trump over Clinton, who was the popular choice. So yun. I came up to that conclusion that sometimes you better choose the popular one, the popular choice, or the popular option than what your heart says. Ganun. So, manood muna tayo. At please comment down below ang inyong mga early favorites for Miss Grand Philippines 2024. Morena. Ha. ko na kinuha ng lahat, ha? Hindi ko na... Hindi ko na kinapture yung mga intro. Hindi lahat. Yung iba may mga nakapture. Pero pinaikli ko na lang. Thank you sa Pageant Nobles for this. Thank you for the video. Let's go to candidate number 3. Wow. Ipapaganon talaga siya. Janice Lubina, ikaw ba yan? Screen recording ko, kaya medyo hindi magandang editing or hindi pa na-edit. Number 4, baguhan sa pageant siguro to. I mean sa national pageant. Marami-maraming training ang kailangan nitong girl na to. Marina's Norte. Ayun na! CJ! Ipapagka-veteran na yung, I mean, hindi naman talaga siya ganun kagandahan, particularly pag bare face. Kahit dun sa bench, parang hindi naman talaga siya talaga sobrang ganda. Pero, yun na nga, she knows how to put her makeup on, maybe. She knows how to project. Maganda to. I like the face. Parang si Atin si Manalo, di ba? And I like the hair.
Oh, 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 oh Okay.
First batch of finalists for Miss Grand Philippines, and please comment down below your early favorites for this year's Miss Grand Philippines pageant. So this is your friend Abato. Thank you very much and see you again.